Hello, everybody. I want to do a video addressing some things on this channel that I wanted to address. In real life stuff. I wanted to really cover. So, there's a lot of reasons as to why I want to update Candy Under My Pillows. And there's a lot of reasons why I want to update Candy Under My Pillows to a revised version of it. Let me put it to you this way. The book and the quality is something that doesn't meet my standards anymore. I'm really trying to improve as being a book writer. And for an example, after I had written Candy Under My Pillows, I found out there was some information that I really felt bad about putting out. Especially when I found out for the first time the truth. And I was in shock of it. And in a lot of ways I'm embarrassed by it. It's content that I want to take off my channel and take off of the book itself and redo the book in a much more thorough and much more concise manner. And I want to be more accurate. I believe when I first wrote the book, I was a very new person when it comes to writing. Because, like I said, doing something like this, I'm very inexperienced at doing, and it's something that takes practice. And I use my books mostly for practice, because in reality, real world, you got to be experienced to be in order to gain it. And how do you gain experience? You write to gain experience. The terminology practice versus practice is something that's a writer's daily life. Now, I had to take almost, believe it or not, 2 months break. Because, number one, my wrist was starting to hurt me. I was really getting into a situation with my left arm because it had been fractured for 30 years. And I had to take breaks because my arm was starting to hurt me. And that's why I went to the doctor. That's why I got a cast on my arm. And so, this is why I'm going to be eventually taking down the old version of Candy Under My Pillows and replacing Candy Under My Pillow Revised. It's going to have a total makeover. So as a makeover with this book, it means that the book needs to get overhauled. There are some sections of the book that is going to be totally taken out. And there are some portions of the book that's going to be added in. And in part of this book, it's going to basically have a total revamp involving the book and be more thorough. And that's one of the things is I really feel that the book is too small. So I'm going to be expanding on the book and try my best to get the book at a bigger rate. compared to what it is, and really, really be concise with events in my life that happened. Now, I'm going to say this because a lot of people will say, well, you shouldn't be talking about the past, blah, blah, blah. Here's the thing. In a lot of ways, you need to embrace your past. Turn around and saying that, quote unquote, these events have happened and try to ignore the past. The past is what molds you to become who you are today. It's kind of like, okay, so this leads with William Shatner, and the one thing that I'm going to stress is William Shatner, as you know, played the role of James T. Kirk. The words were written by Gene Roddenberry, but it leads into the character of Captain Kirk when it was a situation where the episode, the movie Star Trek, had a antichrist or a prophet that was trying to guide the Kirk to this planet, and they were supposedly going to meet God. And it winds up that it wasn't God, it was someone else. It was some alien kind of thing. But Kirk, part of what was going on is that they were going to change a lot of your personality, and that this guy, which was Spock's brother, would be putting that mind meld on it, and to get rid of the embracing the emotion. And Kirk turned around and said, by getting rid of all the negativity. And Kirk said, I need that, because that's what makes me who I am. So, if I was to avoid that negativity about all the negative things that happened in my life, the reality would be that you would be taking out a huge chunk, a part of who I am as a writer. Because if you try to get rid of the past and try to ignore the past, then it's going to wind up making you something that you don't want to become. And I think a lot of people thinks, oh, okay, blah, blah, blah. And they have this attitude that you should not talk about it or not get into the thing. And I really think that if you embrace your situation, say, yes, it happened, it was a bad situation, and not let that be a thing to put your decisions on, it makes you better as an individual. It makes you better as a person. So instead of running away and trying to avoid your past, in a lot of ways you should embrace the past and say, you know what, that's what made me who I am. And originally this book was designed as more of a project because I was angry. But in reality, I want this book to be dedicated in a way of what made me the person that I am today. And I want to get rid of a lot of the negativity in the writing. and more put that writing into a positive direction and really tell people, okay, this is what I came from and this is what I did to overcome that problem. And I really feel that the version that's on Amazon right now is not the version that should represent me in my writing. And that's why Candy Under My Pillow is going to be getting a revisement. I've been talking quite a bit that I've said, I'm not sure if I want to revise Candy Under My Pillow. I've changed my mind on that. And I really feel that a revision of that book deserves more credit to what it is. And so the question a lot of people will ask, when is this book going to be revised? Should I revise it in the next book? No. Absolutely not. I need time to think the book out more thoroughly. And I am going to be thinking this book out during the Christmas season. Now, book-wise, there is going to be a regular season book that's going to be put on Amazon soon. And then there's going to be a Christmas season book. During the Christmas holidays, I'm planning on doing a book and having it available on Amazon, The Candy Under My Pillow, during the Christmas season. But it will not be released until sometime in January or February. I just don't know how much time I'm going to have to write. But like I said, I'm doing everything I can to get these books out as quick as possible. And I really, really, really think that Candy Under My Pillow should be my top priority during the Christmas season. And it's going to make up for a lot of things where there was a big misunderstanding with people, and I'm partly at blame for that. So I am going to do something in order to make up for that. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.